heartfelt namaste to all of you. Today we have with us Shashwata Di. Didi, a warm welcome to you too.
Namaste.
The poet in many of us struggles to come out. Today, Shashwata Di is going to talk about our literary abilities and how we can enhance those abilities. So Didi, what made you want to write on literary abilities of everybody?
Many literary student, literature student, I have seen they have one dream to become a poet or writer. So after going through many horoscopes, students' horoscopes, I felt that I should say something about this. And the main planets, today we will discuss about the main planets and the houses in the birth chart. The main planets are Moon, Mercury, Jupiter, and Venus. And how it is possible? See, to create new or to express your inner feelings, or inner feelings or thoughts in a appropriate manner or appropriate by using appropriate words. And if you are well-versed with any language, then it is the responsible planet is Moon. Moon basically creates poetry.
It also gives imagination.
Yeah, it is imagination, it is mind ability. And next to Moon, it is Mercury, because Mercury is intelligence and the ability to analyze very well the social scenario, because literature is the mirror of our society, contemporary society. And after Mercury, the most important is Jupiter, because Jupiter is knowledge. Knowledge of language and literature, basically it is the grammar part. And after Moon, Mercury, Jupiter comes Venus. The most important, because Venus is creativity. Venus is the rhythm. And Venus give the ability to beautify the words or the sentences you write. So the main planets to become a poet or writer, literary person, the main planets are Moon, Mercury, Jupiter, and Venus. They are responsible to become a poet.
And which houses do we look at?
It is third house and fifth house. Because third house donates your courage. If your feelings, own feelings, your own convictions, your idealism, you want to write down, then you need courage, braveness to write down. And literature, as I told before, literature is the mirror of society. So whatever happening in the society, you should write down that thing. So you need courage. So that's why third house is involved in writing.
And it's third writing house is also penmanship. Yeah.
And next one is the fifth house. Fifth house is your knowledge and awareness of the social scenario.
Right.
And because literature is the treasury of words, so the success of a literary person, being a literary person, the success depends on the proper utilization of words. Then only you can get the success.
Right. So we take up two very well-known poets today, one of them being Shelley. Yes. Who was born in 1792. At that time, he was said to be one of the best poets of his time.
Yeah. Actually, P.B. Shelley is considered as one of the greatest poet in the English language, English literature.
Right.
Actually, Shelley was a romantic poet, and because of his own convictions and idealism, he is a controversial writer also, because of his non-compromising attitude of idealism, and his personal convictions were great. So he wrote down all these things, all his convictions, in his poetry.
Right.
In 1819, he wrote a political poem consists of 14 line, that is called England. And the cloud is the best of Shelley because it is about the perceptual transformation of nature. It is about nature. It is the best known work of Shelley. And Mont Blanc is also the best work of Shelley because it is the interaction between the human mind and the universe. He narrated. If we see, if you discuss the astrological perspective, then we see the Lord of fourth house is Moon sitting in 11th house.
Right.
And aspect on fifth house. And fifth house, I told earlier that fifth house is also considered in writing ability, writing thing. Right. And next to Moon is Mercury. See, Mercury is sitting in the fifth house. Again, it consists, it requires the fifth house. And next even is Jupiter. It is with Mars. Because Jupiter is with Mars, Shelley is very confident about his convictions, and whatever he wrote, he just depicted the actual scenario of his
very logical, very logical based and very practical scenario that he saw. Yeah.
And after Jupiter, it is Venus. And Venus is with Sun. That means it makes this person, Shelley, ambitious also. So if we see the third house, the Lord of the third house, Mercury, is sitting in fifth house.
Right.
Making Trayekadash. So all these planets, that is Moon, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, and Mars, make Shelley very successful poet.
Didi, even when we look into the nakshatra aspect, you know, Jupiter and Mars, they are both sitting in the nakshatra of Chitra, which is Mars's own nakshatra, and it gives a lot of creativity to a person. So, and it's also the Lagna Lord. Connecting the Lagna Lord to all these things makes him a very creative person and a person who's inspired by to do good things and to be very extremely creative in his work with a logical mind.
Obviously.
So we can take up Lord Tennyson now.
Yeah. Lord Tennyson wrote a great deal of poetry, and he was a very emotional and very sensitive person. After the death of his friend Holam, he wrote many poetry. That is Ulysses. The Roman name of Ulysses is Odysseus, and Morte the Author, and Break, 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 and In Memoriam. He wrote so many poems in memory of his friend Holam. And about battle, he has wrote poetry that is The Charge of the Light Brigade. And Mariana is the first poetry which gave him great success as a poet, where he has written imaginary, very vivid and very memorable poetry. And if we see the chart of Lord Tennyson, Lord Alfred Tennyson, then Moon is being the Lord of the second house, sitting in 12th house in exalted sign. So it makes Lord Tennyson very emotional and very creative, and whatever the emotion comes to him, he could narrate it very vividly and very in a very, very polite manner, in a very nice manner to express his emotion. And if we see the Lord of fourth house, that is the public, the Lord of the fourth house is Mercury sitting in the second house, making Budhaditya Yoga with the Sun. And if we see the third house is also very important, because of this importance, the Lord of the third house is Sun sitting with Mercury, Lord of the fourth house and the Lord of the Ascendant, Mercury, sitting with Mercury. So
and this gives him a connectivity. His writings can be connected with the public and the mass.
With public, because this is the mirror of society.
Right.
So if we see the, then we come to fifth house. The Lord of the fifth house, Venus sitting in ascendant itself. So this person is quite aware of the happening of society, quite aware of this thing. And because of this awareness, whatever he narrated very vividly in a very good language. And because he has that command of language, because the Lord of the second house is Moon. And in its exalted sign, it is a very good Nakshatra. So
it's in Rohini Nakshatra, and yeah, Rohini Nakshatra gives a person a very a lot of growth and a lot of creative ability.
Yeah.
So Moon here makes a person extremely creative, and he just learns to grow more and more. And Moon, yeah, with being the second Lord, gives him international name and fame in his creativity.
And if we see the Lord of the 10th house and 7th house, 7th house is your aim of life and 10th house is your work field. So if you see, if the Lord of the 7th house and 10th house, Jupiter, is sitting in 11th house, the Lord of Gain, the Lord of 10th house and 7th house sitting in 11th house, that means the 11th house is the house of gain. And here the Ketu is making very curious, very inquisitive mind. So Moon, Mercury, Sun, Jupiter, Ketu and Venus, all these planets make Tennyson the poet of country.
Yes, and you know, Didi, I'll just, one more thing I would like to say is, yeah, Jupiter and Ketu are in Ashwini Nakshatra. So whoever has, you know, when they have planets in Ashwini Nakshatra, a person would want to do something which is different from others. And Ketu in its own Nakshatra becomes very, very strong.
Yeah.
So it gives him an ability to earn from a resource which is different from others. And so he was also called the poet of England, and he had a lot of name and clout to him.
And I saw one different thing. The Lord of the Ascendant, Lord of the Ascendant Mercury, is making Buddhaditya Yoga. That
right.
means it is ambition with brightness.
Yes. And
it makes brave also, because Mars and Rahu both are sitting in fifth house. Fifth house is the house of knowledge. And Mars is logical brain. So here, Tennyson is very logical in his writing, and choice of words were also very good.
And he did something which was different from what others were doing. That is why he was... We may not be Lord Tennyson or we may not be Shelley, but we definitely can aim to be a better writer, a better person. And a person who can reflect the views of society in a much calm and beautiful manner as they did. If you have these combinations in your chart, do look up as having an ability to do the needful. Thank you so much, Didi, for making us aware of these abilities.